Hello students, welcome to the lecture series of linguistics. And since last four parts, we have been discussing the concept of computational linguistics. So far in discussion, we have seen that computational linguistics is a new area of research in the linguistic world. Computational linguistics is a next step to psycholinguistics, neurolinguistics. We have new branches like computational linguistics, forensic linguistics, corpus linguistics, as such. So if we go through the definition, computational linguistics simply means the study of two different areas, that is computers and linguistics, that is language. The two different things are mixed together for study and for research. So this is the concept of computational linguistics that we have been discussing. As far as the definition is concerned, computational linguistics is interested in providing computational models of various kinds of linguistic phenomena. We discussed this definition in our last part of the lecture. So work in computational linguistics is in some cases motivated from scientific perspective or scientific attitude. In that, one is trying to provide a computational explanation for a particular linguistic or psychological phenomenon. Later on, we discussed the computational linguistics is the application of linguistic theories and computational techniques to problems of natural language processing. As you know that we humans are having a certain part in our brain, and that part is called LAD, language acquisition device, LAD. So this device or this part enables us to learn and to use a language. That part is not developed fully or damaged, what would happen? That can affect us language capability, language power. Right? So computational linguistics does what? Computational linguistics studies the process of language, natural language acquisition in humans. How humans acquire language naturally, right? So the scientists are just copying the same thing in the machines. Like a robot, machines like computers, machines like some softwares or applications, right? So computational linguistics as the study of computer system for understanding and generating natural language. For understanding, the last part yesterday, we saw how simple gadgets are there, right, for communication purpose. How that gadget translates a word or sentence from one language to the other language, right? We also saw Google Translator, how that app simply translates words, paragraphs, sentences from one language to the other language, isn't it? And vice versa. So system of understanding and generating natural language. So main focus of computational linguistics is just two things, just to teach machines the human language and to learn and use human language through computers. So we discussed that learning a language by computer is possible. For example, language translation is there. We saw the video of Google Translator, right? We saw how just you have to scan that word or sentence or paragraph, and automatically translation is available on the screen. So if we select two languages like Spanish and English in Google Translation, right? So we have to just type this word or scan this word via camera, and we can get the English word for that, like amor, love, passion, right? And if we want to translate a sentence from Spanish language to English, we can do this also. So even if we can translate paragraphs or let's say pages But I told you that it is not 100% correct. It is not 100% correct. But attempts are being made to make this translation 100% correct. And let's hope so that in the coming future, that accuracy in the translation from one language to the other would be possible. But as you know, that language is nothing but the product of culture and tendency. So many things are there, many cultural things are there, many local things are there, which are quite difficult to translate from one language to the other. For example, Mangal Sutra, it's almost impossible to translate in English, isn't it? Kanyadan, not possible to translate, right? Shendi, this word is not possible to translate. Lakshman Resha, this word is not possible to translate in other language because all these words are related to culture, right? Upvas, but upvas in Marathi and fast in English. These two things have different meanings. Upvas, we have religious feeling associated with upvas. But in English, fast. Fast is just a fast in other foreign countries. Isn't it? Right? So, Haldi Kumpu, for example. Haldi Kumpu, this word has a cultural touch in India. But same Haldi Kumpu, turmeric and Kumpu don't have Kumpu with this word in English. Isn't it? So, Haldi Kumpu, this word has no that much value like India in America. So that's a problem in translation, right? So Sati Savitri, how would you translate this word Sati Savitri in English? Not possible, isn't it? Rama Rajya, not possible to translate such word, right? So many sentences, many words are there in each and every language, and these words are quite difficult, almost impossible to translate, and that's why we are just fail to translate each and everything from one language to the other language, isn't it? So expectations from computational linguistics for future. So computers may learn natural languages as foreign language. So in the past, what happened? If we want to learn a language, we have to join a tuition class. We have to join a course. We have to visit a person, right? But what happens? In the case of modern research, we can learn a language with the help of computers, right? So we don't have any need to join any tuition classes to some human being. Suppose that if I want to learn a Russian language, right? So in the past, what I had to do, I had to search for a person who could teach me Russian language, isn't it? So I had to pay money for that. I have to invest my time, isn't it? But today I can learn Russian language with the help of computers, with the help of applications, with the help of some computer tools. Isn't that great? So we can learn languages through computers. That's the main target of computational linguistics, right? Suppose that if I want to write a letter from in Punjabi language, okay, in Punjabi language. So what I would do, I would just simply go to Google Translation. I would type some sentences in Marathi, right? And I can translate it in Punjabi language within few seconds, isn't it? So slowly and certainly, I would just try to understand words from Punjabi language, isn't it? Today it looks quite difficult, but in the coming future, right, that computational linguistics would do this thing in a simple way. The other thing is humanly conversation with computers and devices. Humanly conversation. So, main target of computational linguistics what? That one day or the other, computers or electronic gadgets would talk to human beings as humans, like humans. And when this is possible, when that machine would be independent, when that machine would have the power of thinking, isn't it? So in the future, we would have some machines that would think differently, think independently, and would use language at its own. We got the video of Sophia the robot. That Sopo robot smiles, cuts jokes, isn't it? And answers, right? Independently. So, a natural communication between a human and machine is the motto of computational linguistics. Right? So, computers and devices as finest language translators. So, in the coming future, translation would be done through computers, through computer applications, right? Through some gadgets, right? So Google translation is there, Microsoft's translation is there, isn't it? So all these things are there. Voice recognition is also one of the important parts of computational linguistics. Voice recognition, right? So we have thumb recognition in the case of mobile. In the case of mobile. So if you lock your mobile with your thumb, you can open it with your thumb only. Right? If I put the thumb of my sister or any other person, my phone would not be opened because it scans, it understands the thumb impression of your thumb. Isn't it? In the same way, voice recognition is the next step of computational linguistics. Voice recognition. Right? So we would lock our mobiles, lock our gadgets, lock our car, and open it through our voice only. Through our voice only. So the machine would scan the voice, and if that voice is matched like the thumb, what would happen? That machine would open it. Exactly. So that is also the future of computational linguistics. Right? So language and technology, we can say that. Computational linguistics is a discipline between linguistics and computer science, which is concerned with the computational aspects of the human language pattern. It belongs to the cognitive sciences and overlaps with the field of artificial intelligence, a branch of computer science aiming at computational models of human cognition. Computational linguistics has applied and theoretical components. In the first part of our lecture, I just tried to focus on artificial intelligence. Right? As well as the humans are intelligent because they have brains, they have thinking capacity, isn't it? But what man is doing now? Man is creating artificial intelligence with the help of technology in machines. And with the help of that technology, machines would act independently like humans, communicate like humans independently. So machines are becoming intelligent. Robots are becoming intelligent. So artificial intelligence, translation from one language to the other, it is artificial intelligence. Voice recognition, artificial intelligence, right? Thumb scanning, artificial intelligence, isn't it? Eyebrow scanning, it is artificial intelligence, isn't it? So union between computer and language. So AI, artificial intelligence, is the next step of computational linguistics. So the purpose of CL, that is computational linguistics, is develop applications, softwares, apps that deal with computer tasks related to human language, like development of software of grammar correction, word sense disambiguation, compilation of dictionaries and corpora, automatic translation from one language to another. See, if you visit Google Play, Play Store, right? Some dictionaries are available. Dictionaries like English to English, English to Marathi, or Marathi to English, Marathi to Hindi, Hindi to Marathi, Hindi to English, English to Hindi. How this is possible? Because of computational linguistics, isn't it? So we can have dictionaries. Suppose that I am preparing a dictionary that Marathi to French language. I can do it with the help of computational linguistics. So I can translate a word from Marathi to French language or French to Marathi language, isn't it? So I can prepare dictionaries. I can have the automatic translation from one language to the other language. Google translation is the best example of it, isn't it? So developing software, see grammar correction. What happened in the past? We have to learn grammar. We have to read grammar books, isn't it, as a student. But suppose that if I don't have interest or if I don't have any time to do that, to understand or learn a grammar of some language, then what would happen? No problem. Computers are there. So some softwares are available to check the grammar correction. Grammar correction is automatically done with the help of computer application. Yes, it's true. So we have app like Grammarly, right? We have the app like Grammarly, right? Let's check it out. Just a moment.
This is Tyler. Tyler, with Grammarly's help, is writing an email to his boss, Anita. Tyler sits just 15 feet away, though it can feel like the distance to Antarctica, approximately 47 million feet. Tyler desperately wants Anita to like him, but doesn't want to sound unsure of himself. He also wants to explain the incident at the elevator. But this probably isn't the email for that. It's an email asking to lead a team workshop because more collaboration would be really helpful. Beneficial.
See, Grammarly is checking the vocabulary. Okay?
But Tyler worries that Anita doesn't think he's confident, especially after the time he told her,
I'm a suppository of information.
And she gave him this look, since he clearly...
See, this is the wrong use of word. And Grammarly, see the icon, repairs it, corrects it. That it is not suppository, it is repository. So Grammarly, this app helps us to correct the spelling as well as to correct the grammar usage.
He didn't know what a suppository was. This time, Tyler is determined to find the right words. The ones that...
See, Grammarly gives us other synonyms also. See, these are the synonyms or optional words the person can use, isn't it? So, it also solves the problem of vocabulary, isn't it?
Will connect best with Anita, so that when Tyler sends his email, he receives a response in just 4 minutes and 12 seconds. That includes phrases like, I'm impressed, and such initiative. And the distance between Tyler and Anita stops feeling so far. Grammarly, helping you connect. Go to grammarly.com to download.
Grammarly can help you write quickly and confidently, so you never have to slow down at work. Instant corrections make your writing mistake-free, while keeping it short, sweet, and fitting in tone. Join more than 20 million people who use Grammarly to write better every day. Go to grammarly.com to download.
दोस्तों, अब आ गया है टाइम अपनी इंग्लिश को सुधारने का। अगर आप लिखते हैं इंग्लिश में आर्टिकल या फिर आप लिखते हैं इंग्लिश में कोई ब्लॉग और या फिर आप ईमेल मार्केटिंग के लिए ईमेल का कंटेंट तैयार करते हैं वो भी इंग्लिश में और आपकी इंग्लिश थोड़ी वीक है तो अब आपको प्रॉब्लम फेस नहीं करनी पड़ेगी क्योंकि आज की इस वीडियो में मैं आज आपको बताऊंगा एक ऐसे टूल के बारे में जो आपकी इन सभी मिस्टेक को ऑटोमेटिकली डिटेक्ट करेगा और उसको ऑटोमेटिकली करेक्ट भी कर देगा। जी हाँ, इस क्रोम एक्सटेंशन का नाम है Grammarly। ये एक ऐसा स्पेल चेकर टूल है जो आपकी इंग्लिश राइटिंग को बेटर बनाने में आपकी हेल्प करेगा। इसकी हेल्प से आप अपनी पोस्ट में या फिर ईमेल कंटेंट के अंदर अगर कोई आपसे वर्ब की मिस्टेक हो जाती है या फिर कहीं कोमा की मिस्टेक हो जाती है, इसके अलावा सेंटेंस की मिस्टेक या फिर आप किसी भी तरह की कोई ग्रामेटिकल मिस्टेक कर देते हैं तो ये उसको ऑटोमेटिकली डिटेक्ट कर लेगा। आपको भी शो कर जाएगा कि यहाँ पर आपने ये मिस्टेक करी है और उसको ये ऑटोमेटिकली करेक्ट करने का आपको सजेशन भी दे देगा। वहाँ से आप सेलेक्ट करें और वो सारा पैराग्राफ या जो भी आपने आर्टिकल लिखा है या जो भी आपने पोस्ट लिखी है वो ऑटोमेटिकली करेक्ट हो जाएगी। और इसके साथ साथ सबसे बड़ी बात, ये आपकी ईमेल मार्केटिंग में भी हेल्प करेगा क्योंकि वहाँ पर आपको ईमेल कंटेंट लिखना होता है और अगर आपकी इंग्लिश वहाँ पर थोड़ी कमज़ोर होती है या फिर आप ठीक से इंग्लिश नहीं लिखते तो आपके क्लाइंट के ऊपर एक गलत इंप्रेशन पड़ता है, तो उससे भी आपको ये बचाएगा। तो चलिए दोस्तों, देखते हैं कि इसको हमें कैसे इंस्टॉल करना है और कैसे इसको यूज़ करना है। तो हेलो गाइस, मेरा नाम है मनीष, शॉर्ट टेक ट्रेनिंग चैनल।
नीचे आपको सजेशन में दिखाई देगा Grammarly फॉर क्रोम, इस पर क्लिक करें। अब जो सबसे ऊपर आपको एक्सटेंशन दिखाई दे रहा है इस पर क्लिक करें।
इस ऐप इज अवेलेबल
टू क्रोम पे क्लिक करके इसको अपने ब्राउजर में ऐड कर लीजिए। आपको अपनी ईमेल आईडी दे देनी है।
See how Grammarly is checking, right? See, this is wrong use, okay? So Grammarly uses a suggestion, correct use, okay? Like that. We can check the spelling, grammar, punctuation also.
यहाँ पर आपको I'm not sure पे क्लिक करके continue कर देना
है। So many videos are available.
अब नॉर्मली हम क्लिक करेंगे कंपोज पे। अब जैसे ही हम मैसेज बॉक्स पे क्लिक करेंगे नीचे हमें लिखना शुरू करना है।
इस परिवार के अंदर नए हैं यानी कि इस चैनल के ऊपर नए हैं तो इस चैनल को फटाफट कर देना है सब्सक्राइब, साथ ही साथ नीचे जो बेल आइकॉन दिख रहा है उसके ऊपर 2 स्टार की रेटिंग है और 10 मिलियन डाउनलोड्स भी है। Add Grammarly keyboard.
What is Bitrix 24? Free task management, free time tracking.
Orders आपको चाहिए या नहीं? ये आप on. तो कौन सा चाहिए? आप इसको customize. तो माफ कीजिए. तो इसको directly writing भी शुरू कर सकता हूँ. और चाहूं तो इसको चेंज भी कर सकता हूं। ये देखिए, मेरा यू का वाई पी यू हो गया था तो इसको ऑटोमेटिकली यहां पर यू आ गया है। ये यू आ गया। यहां पर मैं क्लिक करता हूं तो मैंने नेम का स्पेलिंग गलत लिखा, तो ये देखिए मुझे करेक्ट स्पेलिंग आ गया। तो ये अपने आप जो है वो आपको करेक्ट स्पेलिंग बताता जाता है। तो यहाँ पर कोई डिफ़िकल्ट अगर मैं स्पेलिंग डालूँ इसको तो क्या डालें जी, यहाँ पर डालते हैं तो ये देखिए डिफरेंट, पूरा टाइप करने से पहले ही मेरे सामने, माफ़ कीजिएगा, डिफरेंस, डिफरेंट, डिफ़िकल्ट, ये सारे ऑप्शंस जो है अपने आप खुल जाते हैं। योर नेम डिफ़िकल्ट ऐसा कुछ हो गया है, खैर इसका कोई मतलब नहीं बनता, लेकिन मैं कुछ आपको वर्ड दिखाने के लिए कर रहा हूँ ये सब। तो यहाँ पर कोई ऑड वर्ड यहाँ पर डाल के देखते हैं, तो फिर से एक बार मैं गलत लिखने की कोशिश करूँगा और देखते हैं कि ये कैसे करेक्ट करता है। तो ये देखिए यहाँ पर आ गया चेक स्पेलिंग, मुझे प्रायोरिटी ही लिखना होता है तो मैं यहाँ पर गलत लिखा है, जिसकी वजह से यहाँ पर चेक स्पेलिंग का मार्क आ गया है। बस इसके ऊपर क्लिक कर दूंगा, स्पेलिंग ठीक हो गया। तो इसी तरीके से दोस्तों आप पूरा का पूरा मेल लिख सकते हैं। और अगर मान लीजिए कि आप यहाँ पर कुछ गलत भी स्पेलिंग लिख रहे हैं, जैसे कि यहाँ पर मुझे लेवल या लीव लिखना है, तो मैंने LEVE किया है, तो उसको ऐसे ही मैं कंटिन्यू करता हूँ और बाकी भी चीज़ें मैं यहाँ पर लिखता चला जाता हूँ। तो अंत में भी आपको जो है वो हर एक वर्ड का, ये देखिए अपने आप चेंज हो जाता है, जो भी गलतियाँ हैं अपने आप सुधार ली जाती हैं। तो इस तरह के रिपीट, तो इस तरीके से जो है वो आप बहुत ही आसानी से यहाँ पर आपका इंग्लिश जो है वो करेक्ट लिख सकते हैं, जिसके अंदर कोई भी ग्रामेटिकल मिस्टेक जो है वो नहीं होगी, और ये चीज़ जो है वो आपको कई जगहों पर काम में आएगी। तो इसी तरीके से दोस्तों आप इसको इस्तेमाल में ला सकते हैं, बस आपको जो है आपका कीबोर्ड ग्रामरली पर यहाँ पर सेट करना होगा। तो ये देखिए यहाँ पर ग्रामरली पर अभी सेट है, तो बस इसी के ऊपर रख दीजिए और आपकी जो इंग्लिश है वो बिल्कुल सही सही यहाँ पर टाइप होगी। भले ही उसके स्पेलिंग्स जो है वो गलत हैं, लेकिन फिर भी ऐप जो है वो अपने आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस से इसको बिल्कुल ठीक कर देगा। तो आई होप दोस्तों आपको ये वीडियो पसंद आया होगा।
सो दिस इज कॉल्ड आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, राइट? सो लैंग्वेज इज ऑटोमेटिकली करेक्टेड। यू हैव सीन that how Grammarly, the app, corrects the language regarding vocabulary, regarding the state of grammar, right? So even though you type wrong spelling, Grammarly automatically corrects it. If there is a mistake of some grammatical structure, Grammarly simply underlines it in red ink. So that indication means it's a wrong use. Right. So, Grammarly points out the mistakes, auto-corrects it, and gives us options also. Suppose that I am using the, a particular word, so Grammarly also suggests me optional words for the same word, that is synonyms, isn't it? So, it helps us. So, I don't have any need to contact some English teacher or a person who has a knowledge of English for help, isn't it? So I can get the help from computer, I can get the help from such softwares and applications. Isn't that great? Right? So learning with the help of computer, right? Using language with the help of computer, right? That's the purpose of computational linguistics, isn't it? So since language is our most natural and most versatile means of communication, linguistically competent computers would greatly facilitate our interaction with machines. The interaction is communication and software of all sorts, and put at our fingertips in ways that truly meet our needs, the vast textual and other resources of the internet. This is the target or main purpose of computational linguistics, isn't it? So in the coming future, there will be many gadgets, many softwares regarding language, and It is not the case that each and everything would be related to English only. No, that's not the case. We are talking about language in general, right? So initially, the software like Grammarly is related to English, but in very future, what would happen? Grammarly Marathi, Grammarly Hindi, Grammarly Urdu, Grammarly French would be created. It is in the first or second stage, isn't it? So we have Grammarly, we have Alexa, the machine. Alexa was in English available, right? But later on, Alexa is now available in many languages in the world, right? So computational linguistics is doing what? Right? They are developing softwares first in English and later on in other languages also, including regional languages. The purpose of CL is to develop applications that deal with computer tasks related to human language, like development of software for grammar correction, as Grammarly we have seen, word sense disambiguation. Which word is more suitable? Which word is more suitable? How? This suggestion is given by some software. For example, suppose that if I say that the house is very good, the house is very good, the bike is very good, isn't it? But if I say that the food is very good, what the software would tell me? No, the food is very good. It's the wrong use of good. The food is very tasty, like that. The food is very tasty. So instead of good, I must use the word tasty, isn't it? Right. So this word suggestion would be given by some software. Like that. So word sense, isn't it? So compilation of dictionaries, as I told you that many applications are available on Play Store of dictionaries, right? English to English, English to Marathi, Marathi to Hindi, like that, right? So if you select English to Marathi dictionary, you have to type the English word and automatically you would get Marathi word for that, right? You have to type the word like father, F-A-T-H-E-R, then what would happen? You would get the word for father in Marathi, that is vadi, bap, like that, right? So dictionary compilation is also possible in computational linguistics. Automatic translation, just we have seen, right? So all these things are just covered under the category of computational linguistics. So if you go to the origins of computational linguistics, we can say that computational linguistics, this movement, this area of research started right from 1950 and in from United States of America, right? In the first phase, the computers to automatically translate text from foreign languages, particularly from Russian scientific journals into English. That was the limited use of computational linguistics in 1950. But if we compare 1950 and to 2021, there would be a drastic change, isn't it? So translation of books are also possible now with the help of computational linguistics, right? We have to just scan the document, right? From one language to the other, translation is possible within few minutes, right? So CL was born as the name of the new field of study devoted to developing algorithms and software for intelligently processing language data. So language data is also used for computational linguistics. Computers were first used for automatic mechanical translation, then their use was extended to deal with linguistics. In order to translate a text, it was observed that one had to understand the grammar of both the languages, right? That was the old notion. Right? Suppose that I want to translate something from Marathi to English, then what was the expectation? That I must learn the grammar of Marathi and English also, right? Including morphology, syntax, semantics, pragmatics, isn't it? But what happens with the help of computational linguistics? Without knowing grammar, I can translate from Marathi to English directly with the help of some software, right? I need not to study the grammar, the morphology, the syntax, semantics, pragmatics of both the languages, isn't it? So one of the earliest and the best known example of a computer program is as called as ELIZA program, right? So the first program developed by computational linguistics was ELIZA, right? So we can say that computational linguistics is nothing but the language experts and computer scientists union. Okay, so it is now used in the case of linguistics, mathematicians, computer scientists, experts in artificial intelligence, logicians, cognitive science. So this field is expanding and expanding itself, right? So computational linguistics has just a new horizon, a great future, right? So artificial intelligence is a new part of computational linguistics nowadays. Right? So research is going on in CL, that is computational linguistics, and many programs, many softwares are meant for human and machine communication. As far as development is concerned, language is a cognitive skill, as you know, which develops throughout the life of an individual. The development process has been examined using a number of techniques. Language is a matter of development. We start learning language right from our birth, right? So we learn one language, two languages, or many languages, right? So how we use and learn language, it is called a development process. So same development process is produced in the case of machines, in the case of computer source. So it enables to learn as children might. So research is going on how children, how kids, they learn language. Okay, so can we allow the computers, allow the softwares such a power? So is it possible that a computer would learn a language automatically? It looks impossible, right? Suppose that a computer is learning Sanskrit automatically. A computer is learning Sanskrit language automatically without any human help. Is it possible? Today, it looks impossible. But in the coming future, may be possible, and that's the target of language, computational linguistics. So how a child learns a language, this process right from the brain is studied by CL, that is computational linguistics. And the same formula would be targeted to be copied, right, in the machines. A model was created for that reason, based on an affordance model, right? So we are just trying to have the same mechanism that we humans have in the childhood, right? The same mechanism is trying to be copied in the machines, isn't it? So all these things are there. So many things are there, but we need not to go into the details like that. Rule-based system approaches are there. That is not our case. These are the application areas. That is machine translation, we have seen, right? Google translation, speech recognition. Machines would recognize my speech. This speech recognition is used in the case of police department, police, CBI, right? When we just have a communication on mobile phone, suppose that. If a criminal speaks to someone on a mobile, and if the police wants to check the voice recognition of that criminal, what would happen? The police takes the sample of the voice of that criminal and processes through some software. And that software tells us whether this sound is of that person or not. I know that each and everybody has a special type of language usage. Our pronunciation changes from person to person, individual to individual. Sentence pattern, toning, all these things changes. But when there is a crime, and suppose that if some criminal is there, right? The law does what? The law tries to recognize the voice of that criminal to prove the offense. बऱ्याच वेळा पोलीस डिपार्टमेंटमध्ये काय होतं, एखादा आवाज त्या आरोपीचा आहे की नाही हे तपासलं जात. पण कसं तपासलं जातं? त्याला सुद्धा सॉफ्टवेअर आहे, राईट? त्याला म्हणतात स्पीच रेकग्निशन सॉफ्टवेअर. ते कोणी तयार केलं? मग कॉम्प्युटेशनल लिंग्विस्टिक्स. प्रत्येक व्यक्ती हा भाषा वेगवेगळ्या पद्धतीने बोलत असतो. दॅट इज कॉल्ड इडियोलेक्ट, इंडिव्हिज्युअल्स लँग्वेज. मी ज्या पद्धतीने बोलतो आहे, राईट, माझा सख्खा भाऊ त्या पद्धतीने बोलणार नाही. त्याची भाषा वेगळी असेल. भाषा वेगळी असेल म्हणजेच काय? बोलण्याची पद्धत, पॉज घेण्याची पद्धत, एखादा विशिष्ट शब्द पुन्हा पुन्हा वापरण्याची सवय, प्रोनाउन्सिएशन, राईट, टोनिंग, वरच्या स्वरात खालच्या स्वरात, याच्यात प्रत्येक जण भाषा वेगवेगळी बोलत असतो. कोणाचा आवाज स्लो, कोणाचा आवाज रफ. मग समजा माझा आवाज आर आर बोलतो सर हे कशा पद्धतीने बोलतात, जर मला चेक करायचं असेल तर माझ्या आवाजाचा एक सॅम्पल घेतला जाईल, तो चेक केला जाईल. चेक कसा होईल? तर यस, स्पीच रेकग्निशन ऍप्लिकेशन, राईट. ती फाईल त्यामध्ये स्कॅन होईल, ऑडिओ फाईल, आणि ते सॉफ्टवेअर आपल्याला सांगत की हा आवाज त्या व्यक्तीचा आहे की नाही. बरेच क्रिमिनल्स बघा फोनवरून धमक्या देतात, राईट, खंडणी गोळा करण्यासाठी धमक्या देतात, राईट. पोलीस काय करतात? मग फोन टॅप करतात. तुम्ही ऐकलं असेल, फिल्म मध्ये पाहिलं असेल बघा, फोन टॅपिंग केली जाते. टॅपिंग केले म्हणजे रेकॉर्डिंग असते. सपोज दॅट, राईट, पूजाला मी फोन केलेला आहे आणि पूजाला मी धमकी दिली, फॉर एक्झाम्पल, ओके, एक्झाम्पल, ओके, पूजाला मी धमकी दिली. पूजाने काय केलं? मग माझा आवाज तिच्या फोन मध्ये रेकॉर्ड करून घेतला, राईट. पूजा गेली पोलिसांकडे, पूजाने माझ्याबद्दल कंप्लेंट दाखल केली की बोरसे सरांनी मला धमकी दिली. पोलीस मध्ये पुरावा काय? पूजा काय म्हणणार? माझ्याकडे ऑडिओ क्लिप आहे. मग काय होणार? पोलीस ते ऑडिओ क्लिप घेणार, मलाही बोलवणार पोलीस स्टेशनला, आणि माझा आवाजाचा एक नमुना ते घेणार, राईट. आणि पूजाच्या फोन मध्ये असलेली ऑडिओ क्लिप आणि माझा आवाजाचा नमुना हे काय होणार? मॅचिंग. त्या सॉफ्टवेअर मध्ये काय होईल? मॅचिंग. आणि ते सॉफ्टवेअर सांगेल की फोन मध्ये रेकॉर्ड झालेला आवाज हा बोरसे यांचा आहे की नाही, राईट. असेल तर यस म्हणेल, नसेल तर नाही म्हणणार. म्हणेल म्हणजे कशावरून? That machine, that software would scan each and every word, each and every pronunciation from both the clips. The dubhi clips ja ahet, they have kya hoti? Compare hoti. Pratyek shabd, pratyek pronunciation compare hoti. Isn't it? But this, ya software cha upyog he criminals la shodhnya sathi jasti jast pramana mhate kela jato. That is speech recognition. Mobile phones aajkal bareche स्पीच रिकग्निशन आवाजाने सुद्धा चालतात, राईट. सो मॅन मशीन इंटरफेसेस, अलेक्सा, राईट. आय गिव द एक्झाम्पल, इंटेलिजंट वर्ड प्रोसेसिंग, दॅट इज स्पेलिंग करेक्शन, ग्रॅमरली फॉर एक्झाम्पल, ग्रॅमर करेक्शन, सेम इज द केस ग्रॅमरली. सो सच काइंड ऑफ ऍप्लिकेशन आर मेड अंडर कॉम्प्युटेशनल लिंग्विस्टिक्स. अँड with the help of these applications, right, many interesting things are there, right? So it is nothing but opening the new areas of facilities, right? See, Grammarly, English, Spanish. I am just typing these three lines over here. It is automatically translated over here in Spanish language, isn't it? So you can download it from Play Store, right? This is how translation works from one language to the other language, right? Document management, we can have computational linguistics. Find relevant documents in collections. Catch plagiarism, Wangmaicharya. Suppose that if I just copied some material from other book and tried to publish, right? Claiming that it is mine, right? This thing is also can be catched with the help of computational linguistics. Wangmaicharya, dusryacha material copy karaycha ani majha navane chapaycha. Hi ji chori ahe, he suddha computational linguistics madhun apan काय करू शकतो उघड पाहू शकतो. समजा एखादा पीएचडी थेसिस आहे, राईट, एखाद्याचा रिसर्च पेपर आहे, तर मी इंटरनेटवरून कॉपी केला, पेस्ट केला, प्रिंट आउट केले, त्याला माझं नाव देऊन टाकलं, ते माझं मटेरियल आहे, राईट. पण माझं मटेरियल आहे माझ्यावर कोणी विश्वास ठेवणार नाही, कारण एक सॉफ्टवेअर आहे अँटी प्लॅगरिझम, त्यामध्ये माझं मटेरियल, माझा पेपर, माझा थीसिस स्कॅन केला जाईल, राईट. आणि कॉम्प्युटेशनल लिंग्विस्टिक काय करेल, ते ऍप्लिकेशनच्या माध्यमातून हे इंटरनेट पूर्ण स्कॅन होईल. बघा इंटरनेट, इंटरनेटमध्ये किती पेजेस काय काय असणार आहे, सगळा डाटा स्कॅन होईल. आणि समजा तो डाटा ऑलरेडी कोणाच्या नावावर रजिस्टर असेल आणि मी काय करतोय, चोरी करतोय, तर माझी चोरी लगेच पकडली जाईल. सॉफ्टवेअर लगेच सांगणार आहे, या व्यक्तीने इथून इथून हा डाटा चोरलेला आहे, याला पकडा, हा चोर आहे. सो एक्झॅक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम डॉक्युमेंट्स इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल. क्लासिफाय डॉक्युमेंट्स, सेक्शन वाईज क्लासिफिकेशन, समराइज डॉक्युमेंटेशन, समरी, राईट, इट इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल इन द कमिंग फ्युचर. समराइज डॉक्युमेंट्स कलेक्शन ऑल्सो, राईट. सो इफ यू आर हॅव्हिंग हिप ऑफ information and you want to classify it, right, then CL comes to your help. तिकडे तुम्हाला डाटा असेल, तुम्हाला क्लासिफाय करायचा असेल, वर्गीकरण करायचं असेल, तर कॉम्प्युटेशनल लिंग्विस्टिक तुमच्या मदतीला येतं. क्लासिफिकेशन, ओके, दिस डाटा अंडर दिस रो, दिस डाटा अंडर दिस रो. सो दिस थिंग, the data is classified, okay, automatically, right? So we can say that this is computational linguistics, right, the union between computer and language. So many new areas would open in the very coming future with the help of computational linguistics. I hope that I have tried my level best to illustrate the concept of computational linguistics. So thank you very much.